In this video, I will demonstrate how we can use the signal generator and signal modulation functions of the TinySA and how we can use the TinySA to analyze AM and FM modulation. We start by putting the TinySA in low output mode. The level is minus 15 dB. We have no modulation and we switch on the output. The signal appears on the TinySA that we use for the analysis and we can zoom in a bit to have a bit of view on the harmonics. As you can see, the second harmonic is very low and there's a bit of a third harmonic, but it's below minus 40 dBc. The next step is to switch on the modulation so we can analyze. In this case, we will be using the AM modulation and with a frequency of 2 kHz. When we look to the analysis TinySA, we see something very strange. The level that used to be constant is now jumping up and down. And that's because over the sweep, over the frequency range, the TinySA at some moment in time checks the level of the signal at 10 MHz. And that could be anywhere within the AM modulation cycle. So the AM depth modulation depth influences the measured level and is randomly sampled. And that's why you see it wildly moving around. The next step for the analysis is to zoom in. And we zoom into 10 MHz. And we go for a span of 0.1 MHz. We now have to take one more step to be able to see the AM modulation. And that is because the TinySA uses an automatic gain control, which gets confused from the AM signal. So we have to switch off the automatic gain control. We do that by going into expert config, the next switch, and we disable the AGC. And we leave the LNA enabled. And that gives us the wanted signal. You see here the center of the modulation, the carrier and the two sidebands. And far out, you have some higher harmonics of the modulated signal. If I now increase the frequency, for instance, to 5 kHz, you will see that the sidebands move farther out. It is also possible to read the modulation frequency directly from the display. The center here is at 10 MHz, the carrier. And because we have 10 kHz per division, you can see the sidebands are in the middle of a division, so they are 5 kHz away from the carrier. So the modulation frequency is 5 kHz. Now this analysis is nice and it shows us the netto effect of the modulation, but it also would be nice to be able to demodulate the signal and look to the actual signal over time. That is possible. And for that, we have to use the continuous or zero span mode. So we go back into the frequency menu. We go for zero span, 10 MHz. And here you already can see the AM modulated signal. But because this is still in dB unit, it's not well possible to see the depth of the modulation. And for that, I go to level unit and I select volt. And now I have a display which gives me the volts just like an oscilloscope of the modulated signal. It's also possible to count the cycles that we see here and count the time per cycle. And to do that, I first go to display and pause the sweep. So we can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and a bit, so about 8.5. And we have the total sweep time 1.8 milliseconds. So if we divide 1.8 milliseconds by 8.5, we get about 0.2 milliseconds, and that corresponds nicely with 5 kilohertz. And that concludes the analysis of the AM modulation. In the next part, we will look at the FM modulation. To do that, we switch the source TinySA, the signal generator TinySA, to narrow FM 2 kHz, and the rest of the settings we keep the same. We start with the wide scan of the FM modulated signal, and as you can see, FM modulated signals do not jump up and down, so we can use the default settings of the TinySA, no need to switch off the AGC. Next step is to zoom in, and immediately we will go to the center 10 MHz and a span of 0.1 MHz. And we observe something very special. What you see here is the FM modulated signal, and in the middle of that signal there's a dip. And the dip occurs if there is a very special relationship between the frequency deviation and the modulation frequency. And this dip occurs if you have a modulation of 2 kHz with a frequency deviation of 5 kHz. If I change the modulation, for instance, to 1 kHz, you see the sharp dip disappears. And if I set it to 3 kHz, the sharp dip is gone completely. So when we use 2 kHz, we have the nice sharp dip in the center that signals that we are in the right relationship between the modulation frequency and the modulation depth. But it would of course also be nice to be able to watch to a demodulated FM signal. Now, officially the TinySA cannot support this because you can use zero span mode, but there's no FM demodulator in the TinySA. However, there's a nice trick that we can use. And for that, I will switch to zero span mode, but not to 10 MHz, but to 10.35 MHz. And I will set the receiver bandwidth to resolution bandwidth to 600 kHz. And as a next step, I switch to the unit to volt. Now here you see the FM modulation appear as an amplitude modulation. And that's possible because I've positioned the 10 MHz input signal at the skirt of the resolution filter. So depending on the deviation from 10 MHz, you get more or less amplitude in the level detector. And this is exactly the same as how they used to do FM demodulation in the past. So by using the side, the skirt of the resolution bandwidth filter, you can do FM demodulation. We are modulating here with 2 kHz, so you see that the amount of cycles is indeed around 4. And the modulation depth cannot be directly interpreted because the modulation depth depends on the steepness of the skirt of the resolution filter. So that cannot be immediately read out. To demonstrate how this demodulation using the skirt of the resolution filter works, I will first switch the center frequency to 10 MHz. And as you can see, there's only a bit of noise within one or half a decibel. So the basic FM modulation has disappeared. And if you now switch to a span of 1 MHz, you see here the 10 MHz marker at the top of the resolution filter. And of course there it doesn't demodulate. But if I now move the marker to 10.35 MHz, you see it's on this steep skirt of the resolution filter, which is almost linear, and that will nicely demodulate any change in frequency and translate it to an amplitude modulation. And this concludes the demonstration of the modulation analysis capabilities of the TinySA.